Good evening. Some good discussion going on over there. My name is Mark Model, and I have the privilege of being the principal here at Urey Middle School. It's an honor to be standing before you this evening to celebrate, and that's exactly what this is, the great accomplishments of these students to my left. Tonight, we're going to honor 84 students for a wide array of awards. These numbers, the number 84 does not include the awards that will be given during noontime grade level awards next week. Before we begin tonight, I'd like to take a second to make sure that you have your cell phones either in silent or off mode. That's you too. Several of tonight's awards are going to involve multiple award winners. During those award presentations, I ask you to hold your applause until all recipients have received their awards. If you are not aware, tonight's program is being video streamed live on the internet on the John Glenn School Corporation, as well as the Urey Middle School website. It will be archived there as well if you wish to go back and look at it anytime in the future. I'd like to thank Mr. Jim Hauser and Mr. Andy Stegmiller for coordinating and running the live video stream tonight. To my right are the dedicated staff members who make Urey Middle School such a wonderful school. I'd like to thank each of them for their dedication, hard work, hours of work, and effort throughout the entire school year. We do not have any school board members nor our superintendent present tonight because we have a school board meeting going on at the same time. Otherwise, I would introduce them. Final note, I'd like to thank Ms. Renee Schneider, who is our UMS Athletic Guidance Secretary, who has coordinated tonight's awards program. Lots of work, lots of nervousness, lots of sweat, and lots of double and triple checking things on her part is making tonight successful. Our first award tonight is the Support Staff Member of the Year. Each year, staff members at Urey nominate and then vote on a Support Staff Member of the Year as well as a Teacher of the Year. Staff members' votes determine who is selected for each of these awards. Tonight, we'd like to honor Mrs. Emily Winchell, who was selected as the UMS Support Staff Member of the Year. Mrs. Winchell was nominated by fellow staff members at UMS, one of which said, and I quote, "Emily has been a positive influence to so many students who need extra help within the classroom. She is always willing to help students and to seek out their positives, as well as to compliment and encourage them to do their best. I've also enjoyed her eagerness to help students and have appreciated all of her assistance in the classroom this year. Emily is a great role model for our students here at Urey. Unfortunately, Mrs. Winchell has 3 young children and a husband who is currently at the school board meeting and is unable to be here because she's with her children. But congratulations to Mrs. Emily Winchell." Middle School Teacher of the Year Award is presented to Mrs. Ladora Smith. Mrs. Smith received her undergraduate degree from Ball State University, go Cardinals, in the 2015-16 school year. This is her 19th year teaching. She's taught at Emma E. Booker Elementary in Sarasota, Florida, Knox High School, Walkerton Elementary, John Glenn High School, and of course here at Urey Middle School. She's previously been recognized as the 2009 UMS Teacher of the Year. No 2 school years are ever the same for Mrs. Smith. She's continually trying new ideas and approaches. Just this year, she's taken on the role of teaching two new math classes, a seventh grade math class, as well as an eighth grade math class. Mrs. Smith's work has repeatedly been used as a model for other teachers with respect to educational planning, technology integration in the classroom, and relationship building with students. Here's what her peers had to say about her. She gives 100% to her students and colleagues. She goes above and beyond every single day. She has a smile on her face every single day. And I will say more so at the end of the year now than that's true for all of us. She puts the best interest of her students above everything else. Congratulations to Mrs. Ladora Smith. Mrs. Harrington and Ms. Bennett will now present math awards.
The Mathematics Award is based on academics, attitude, the willingness to do their very best, and participation in the math classroom. Our first award is awarded to a seventh grader who is in my Algebra 1 class, Corey Barker. The Algebra 1 award goes to Evan Dreibelbitz. These are students in the eighth grade that go to the high school for geometry class. The geometry award is awarded to Abigail Hauser.
Next up is language arts, Mrs. Sarber, Mr. Buss.
I tend to be a little more long-winded, so I asked Mrs. Sarber just to stay put. She's caring more than just herself nowadays. For some reason, I can already hear my colleagues moving in their seats behind me here, anxious about what I'm about to say. No need to worry. I'll behave, Mrs. Harrington. I promise. So last year, I picked on Taylor Murray. Wherever you are, Taylor. Well, just a bit. She deserved it, and she even liked it. But I won't be doing that tonight. I've grown up a little bit, so Taylor, you're off the hook. However, I will use this very public opportunity to take a shot at Jill Sweden. Which means you have to come up here, Jill. Jill Sweden, ladies and gentlemen. Face the audience. You a little nervous? Yeah, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you something about Jill. She is honest. And I mean brutally honest. I'll give you a few examples. One time, she exclaimed to the entire class, "Mr. Buss, when I came here, I was told how awesome you are, but I thought you totally stunk." Yeah. Another. One day, she looked at my clothes in the hallway and yelled, "You look like a hobo." Combine that with the time when she told me I am like an old lady, and now I'm being called an old hobo lady. So Jill is an honest person. So am I. And now is my opportunity to be honest about Jill in front of a crowd of people, even being streamed live online. I believe this is what we call karma. Her face is secret. Yeah, and that does impress me. When considering who to recognize in language arts, I begin with grades, participation, accelerated reader points, etc., and this does dwindle the number significantly. The challenge comes at separating these students. To do so, let me tell you a Jill Sweeta story. I saw on her first writing assignment in advanced language arts that she is not the typical writer. See, I've been teaching for 13 years now. Over 1,500 students read tens of thousands of essays and do not recall being blown away by a student's writing ability like hers. I've been so impressed that I've even used her ability to my advantage by having her proofread my own work. And when did you know? She always finds a few errors. Her vocabulary is colossal, and as a result, I call her walking dictionary. Being 24 years her elder and a typical egotistical man, it was hard for me to accept that her vocabulary is larger than mine. I've come to terms with that now. But this is just merely the exposition of the Jill Sweeta story. The important part of the story took place in the first semester. At this stage of the year, she had already established herself as a superior writer to me, and I enjoyed reading her work very much, until her Robinson Crusoe essay. She wrote an essay that I would say was not typical Sweeta-esque. It was just okay. So I called her out on it. My comments, admittedly, were straightforward, harsh, critical. And I gave her the same honesty she gives me. In a nutshell, I told her this stinks, it's unacceptable, don't ever do it again, and don't settle for a subpar performance again. And at the time, I really did not know her that well. I had no idea how she would respond to my challenge. I found out later that I had hurt her feelings. So at the moment of reading her jerk teacher's comments, she faced a decision. Accept my challenge or blow me off. Many students do the latter. She accepted the challenge. She not only wrote of the ability I demand, but raised it 3 levels. Her Tom Sawyer, honestly, is one of the best, her Tom Sawyer essay, I should say, is one of the best I've ever read. She not only excelled in writing, but in all assignments, grammar, literature, and even those dreaded speeches. It is fair to say I am now a fan of hers. So with this stage, I would like to recognize the language arts efforts and skills. Whoa, young lady, come back here. You don't get off this easy. You called me a hobo, remember? As exhibited, Jill does not cower from challenges. So I got one last challenge for you tonight. Her good friend and I know her absolute craze for pink and pink camouflage clothing. Got you a little gift in a pink bag.
No.
It's beautiful.
No. No.
Hey, your peers are really interested in this shirt. Because that had a challenge. Because your peers have a reward awaiting them. If you wear it all day tomorrow, and you put up with my torments, the entire class can expect extra credit, Jill. So don't cower.
This is my third year here at Urey, and each year
off of their work ethic, which this year was a problem because I had 10 kids who all put in 100% every day. I could have based it on a number of things, like their AR points and whether they were able to read to their goal, or whether they were able to complete every homework assignment. But the challenge is, in my advanced class, I've got a bunch of people who all were qualified for this award. So I have to try and pick one. So naturally, I narrowed out all the boys who irritate me every day and the girls who talk too much. Usually the ones that sit in the front row right in front of my desk. I'm just joking. And I had to try and pick somebody who has had a positive attitude about the coursework. And when I tell them they're going to have extra homework assignment because some of the kids in the class were talking, one who doesn't grumble and roar and make everybody else feel bad, but one who just quietly does the work, but also does an amazing job of it. We assigned a research paper this year where they all had to look into the colleges and universities and plan out their future. And they had to look at what kinds of things they wanted to study and who offers that. And I had one student whose paper blew my mind because of how much effort she had put into it and how much thought went into it. And I think she did a very nice job. And that was what kind of helped me narrow down my top 10 to 5 to 2 to 1. So I want to thank and congratulate Claire Hine for all of her hard work.
Didn't get him a gift. And next up, for Health and Physical Education is Mrs. Pam Parrish.
We have several things to pass out. This year I like to think it's because we're the best teachers, but we know that's not the case. We just have a lot of things that we're responsible for. And the first one is our health awards. Top students in health were chosen on the basis of their grade point average and overall effort and enthusiasm for health. This year's seventh grade award goes to Ariel Tisberg.
Winkleman. And Emma Dolinsky. Emma needs to stay. Emma is outstanding in the fitness, and she always does her best, but one of her major things that she's great at are the pull-ups. And every year, last year she dumbfounded me. She did 15, and I just couldn't believe it, because normally the girls struggle to get one. And so her challenge this year, I think for herself, was to try to break that eighth grade record, which was 12. She tied it in the fall when we did our pretest, and then she's been working. I think she does a lot at home on her own, but she finally got the name all to herself, the award all to herself, with 13 pull-ups this year to break the record. I think that's all. Family Consumer Science.
Average, but class participation and just a general interest in the class. And this year's seventh grade award winner is Emma Hsu. And the eighth grade Family and Consumer Science Award goes to Taylor Murray. Education, Mrs. Dara Goodlink.
This year is the first year we implemented a program called Project Lead the Way. It is a program that's a national program. The course that we taught this year was design and modeling. It's based on the engineering design process, and we used a program called Autodesk Inventor, which we were able to create 3D models on the computer. So I based my decision on the top students based on the interest, the ability with the Autodesk Inventor, and also with the highest percentage in the class. I have a certificate for them, but I also have a 3D printed award. We just got a 3D printer about a month and a half ago, and I finally figured it out. This is Legos that put together. There are a total of 5 Legos on here. They do come apart, but I don't suggest you do that because they were really hard to put back together. So my seventh grade award goes to Corey Barker. And my eighth grade award goes to Brianna Hellinger. Accelerated reader books and take comprehension tests on them as part of their classroom grade. Passing test scores earn students points according to the level of the book read. All students are rewarded from the Media Center at point levels of 25, 50, 100, 200, 300, 500, 600, and 700 points. There are students who voluntarily choose to go beyond the classroom point requirements. Our top reader this year shows a definite love of reading. With 829 points, Mrs. Morris and I are proud to give the Media Center AR Award to last year's recipient and this year's Abby Hauser. Next presenter with band awards is Mr. Dan Fortlander.
7th, 8th, and 8th grade concert band participated in the Indiana State School Music Organizational Band Contest this past April, where they performed three varied selections and were evaluated by a panel of judges. These student musicians gave an outstanding performance and received the coveted gold rating. There are many talented young musicians that I have had the privilege to work with, and I wish I could give many more awards for the band. For 7th grade, I'd like to give this award to Riley Jean. Also for 7th grade, Connor Ford. And for 8th grade, this young lady has quite a talent. We don't have an orchestra here, and she took a solo and ensemble solo at the Group 1 level. Group 1 level is college level material and received a gold rating at the state finals. So I'd like to give this award to Abby Hauser. And also a young man that I understand is leaving us this year. He switched instruments for me just because we needed a voice that was not in the band, and I asked him to make the switch, and he did. And this goes to Freeman Patterson. And next up is Mr. Jordan Dollins.
So my job is really interesting. When it comes to teaching choir, especially at the middle school level, I consider the voice one of the most personal things. It's the only instrument that you are born with. And so being as such, it's a very, very personal talent that you have to let other people see and have to let other people hear to make my job work, getting a bunch of voices together to make a choir. It's also really exciting that the kids that I'm gonna honor tonight hopefully will stay with us. Mr. Fortland and I are lucky in the sense that we don't only get to see kids for 1 year or for 2 years, but hopefully we get to see kids for 6 years, you know, half of the time that they are in school, which is really exciting to see the talent that's here and imagine what that talent's gonna be 5 or 6 years down the road. The two 7th graders I'm gonna honor tonight have really helped their group excel. Mr. Fortlander talked about the band going to ISMA contest and receiving a gold rating. The middle school choirs also, both 7th and 8th grade, went to contests and received gold ratings this year, and I attribute that much in part to the students that I'm gonna honor tonight. So for the 7th grade, I would like to honor as our male leader, Sam Carson. And as a leader in our alto section, Alexis Baer. For our 8th graders, they had a tough job this year. There are 16 singers in 8th grade this year. And if you have been present at any of our concerts, they're an amazing group of kids. And so it was difficult for me to pick just two out of those 16 kids. But the two I would like to honor tonight are, for the ladies, Brianna Helminger. And for the gentlemen, Nico DeMonte. And now social studies.
Present the 8th grade social studies award. The criteria for this award is based on GPA and academic achievement, great attitude and effort in the area of U.S. history, and this year's recipient is Lydia Henry.
year's seventh grade award goes to a student who has not just showed a willingness to learn, but an eagerness to learn something that I know everyone loves, the subject of social studies, so I know you can relate to this, but this individual has blown me away with his knowledge of countries and the eagerness to learn African countries, Asian countries. I know you guys are getting excited just hearing me talking, but I mean, just amazing drive to learn those countries, and not just do level one, but we have this program where they have to take a country, they have to size it, they have to rotate it, and they have to put it on a blank map, and then it disappears, and they have to do the next one. And he got every single Asian country in the world correct. So very, very impressive. I don't know, don't challenge him to any kind of contest with that. So I want to give this award to Mr. Sam Carson. Up next is Mr. Marvin.
Perfect attendance doesn't happen very often. It's a rare thing. 2 years of perfect attendance is more rare. This year we have seven eighth graders who've achieved perfect attendance throughout all of their seventh and all of their eighth grade careers, and I'd like to honor them. When I say your name, please come forward. When you're done, just stay behind me, and then when you're all done, you can have a seat. First of all, Mr. Logan Blount. Claire Hain. Bryce LaRose. Taylor Murray. Ariel Sanchez. Hunter Rush. That cast is a result of a school accident. And Jared Walker. Mrs. Feuda will now present TriCap Awards.
The North Liberty TriCap Service Award is given to students who exhibit daily use of the life skills in the classroom, towards others, and as an overall confident student. This year's TriCapa Service Award recipients will each receive a certificate and a $25 gift card. Our winner for the young ladies is Hope Dehoff. And our winner for the young men is Kobe Dean. Presenter is Mr. Damon Gross.
On behalf of the Walkerton TriCapa, I'd like to present this award to the members that are proud to have chosen one of the Urey Middle School students. Hope you look upon this not only as an honor, but also as a responsibility. It is our belief that we will continue to hear great things about you in the future. We are proud to present you with a $50 award. For the boys, it goes to Evan Drivelbus. For the girls, it goes to Abigail Griffiths. Next will be Mr. Brown.
Probably for some of you, this is like a nightmare with me up here in front of you, considering I had you as students. Well, get over it. Anyway, I enjoy all my students, really. For the athletics, first, I'd like to thank all the students that participated this year and represented the school. And I also would appreciate, all the help from parents who stayed after school to take care of teams that practiced late, came to track meets and filled in. You were a tremendous help, and it helped make the athletic program run as well as it does. I do want to introduce some people tonight that take care of your children at events, and I would like for them to stand up and hold your applause, please. To my far right is Coach Groves. He was a 7A girls basketball and 8A boys basketball coach. Pam Parrish, 8A volleyball. To my right, Gavin McNeely, boys track. Aaron Sarber, girls track. And in the crowd, yeah, you're not going to get out of it, Melissa Williams, assistant track coach. And Jennifer Art, you may stand up too, assistant track coach also. Please give these people a round of applause. We did have some highlights this year. We had a special basketball team in the 7A boys. They had an undefeated season. They were NSC regular season champions and NSC tournament champions. For boys basketball in 8A, they were the NSC tournament champions. The 8A girls basketball team were the NSC regular season champions. These teams are the last NSC champions. The conference is no more, so you are going to be king forever. Nobody can knock you off of that pedestal, so enjoy. And in girls golf, the girls team captured two championships, the Stanley Clark Invitational and the Falcon Invitational this spring. We'll get to the awards now. The All Sports Award. I would like for the individuals who receive this to stay back behind the three of us and hold your applause so we're done. The requirements for this, you need to letter in three sports during the 7th grade year and the 8th grade year. So, all sports awards, please. Margaret Knowlton. Grayson Fansler. Nicholas Frankowitz. Brenna Perry. Emma Dolinsky. Mm-hmm. Zachary Mago. Brenna Wright. Jack Vukovitz. Daniel Taylor. Claire Hayne. Evan Dreibelbus. Now we can applaud for these individuals. Okay, the Mental Attitude Award. The individual must letter in at least two sports during eighth grade year, show good attitude in all facets of life. The girls recipient this year is Claire Hayne. The boys recipient, Gabriel Weiss. Academic Award, the individual must letter in at least two sports eighth grade year and must have grades of A and B. We have co-winners in the boys, Grayson Fansler. And Zachary Mago. For the girls, Taylor Murray. Most improved, lettering at least two sports eighth grade year, shows significant improvement in sports throughout the year. The boys recipient, Jack Vukovitz. And the girls, Riley Miller. The all-around athlete takes three sports to get this one. Outstanding in two sports, above average in one. Show good mental attitude in sports and do well in the classroom. We have a tie for the boys. Zachary Mago. And Daniel Taylor. And for the girls, Emma Dolinsky. Next, we will have the DAR Award, Mrs. Nancy George. Thank you.
Good evening. It's always a pleasure to come to Urey Middle School and be a part of your awards program. Each year, the DAR Daughters of the American Revolution is one of 88 chapters in Indiana to give this award, Good Citizenship, in the junior high. It goes goes to an exceptional student completing the eighth grade. And this award is given to 33 schools in St. Joe County. So we cover our bases well. Now, the person from your class was chosen by the full school faculty, and on the basis of honor, of service, of courage, of leadership, and patriotism. And so, it gives me great pleasure to announce this year's winner, Ms. Camden England. Will you come forward, please? This is a great question, sir. I'm gonna take time and pin it on you.
Each year, the Urey Middle School staff recognizes one eighth grade student, it may be a girl or it may be a boy, who has made the most all-around improvement in the areas of academics, attitude, citizenship, and character. This award is given in memory of a former student who drowned in a tragic accident on the last day of school several years ago. Bob Clark was not a straight-A student, not an honor roll student, but he was, however, a good student because he always worked hard to make the most of his potential. And I remember that day when that happened because he was in my class here when I was in eighth grade. This year, the student that best exemplifies these qualities is Bryce Whitmer. Next is Mr. Monlin.
The American Citizenship Award honors students who have shown with both their words and their actions that they possess the qualities and characteristics we hope to instill in all students. This award is designed to recognize students who consistently exhibit the kinds of behaviors we want to see displayed in our schools and our communities. At Urey Middle School, we have a Caught Doing Good program. These students are the poster child of Caught Doing Good because they do things good for others when they don't know anyone is watching. Congratulations to Annalie Sutton. And Riley Miller. Mrs. Hudgen will now help me present the President's Award for Educational Excellence.
The Presidential Award for Educational Excellence was established to encourage students to achieve high academic standards by recognizing and rewarding them for educational excellence. In order for students to qualify for this academic award, they must maintain a 3.0 GPA throughout all of 7th and through the 3rd grading period of their 8th grade year. I would ask that you please hold your applause until all the students' names have been announced as they come up to receive their award. Okay. I am pleased to present the Presidential Award for Educational Excellence to the following students. Hannah Abring. Victoria Anderson. Charles Arndt. Joel Ayers. Ethan Baker. Jacob Borden. Ashley Bolds. Meg Bronke. Madigan Burns. Tristan Carrasco. Isabel Cochran. Kobe Dean. Hope DeHoff. Emma Dolinsky. Nicholas DeMonte. Evan Dreigelbus. Ryan Eggleston. Caden England. John Fan. Grayson Fansler. Gavin Finch. Mackenzie Fockler. Nicholas Frankowitz. Martin Garcilaso. Bryce Goble. Abigail Griffiths. Brianna Helminger. Lydia Henry. Faith Holdeman. Annalise Hooten. Abigail Hauser. Trace Jones. Zachary Judy. Grace Kaser. Julia Kaser. Maya Karga. Margaret Knowlton. Dessa Lang. Craig Lenig. Bryce LaRose. Dustin Luddington. Zachary Mago. Christian McElway. Autumn Michaels. Riley Miller. Leslie Munoz. Taylor Murray. Chase Odin. Joey Parker. Freeman Patterson. Brenna Perry. Morgan Plunkett. Deja Pompey. Matthew Rice. Ariel Sanchez. Joshua Sleek. Christiana Smith. Daniel Taylor. Keegan Tibbs. Cody Tove. Jack Bukovitz. Jared Walker. Gabriel Weiss. Bryce Whitmer. Jordan Winkleman. And Kayla Wright.
Mrs. Harrington will now present Outstanding 7th Grade Student Awards.
The Outstanding 7th Grade Students are nominated by their teachers and voted on by the staff. We base our award on scholarship, participation in school activities, character, attitude, and integrity. This year, the outstanding 7th grade girl, Taylor Cascade. The outstanding 7th grade boy, we have co-winners Corey Barker and Sam Carson. Mr. Groves.
The outstanding 8th grade is also nominated by their peers and voted on by the staff with the same principles: scholarship, participation, school activities, character, attitude, and integrity. I'm proud to announce the Boy Award to Grayson Fansler. Outstanding girl, Taylor Murray. Mr. Modlin, you next.
Distinguished Honor Roll. The following four 8th grade students have earned recognition on the Distinguished Honor Roll each term during their middle school career. Distinguished Honor Roll means they've earned straight A's, an A in every class throughout their middle school career. The front of the medal that I'm going to present them has the lamp of knowledge. On the back is the inscription, 2-year Distinguished Honor Roll, and then their name. Congratulations to the following students for their high level of academic achievement during both their 7th and 8th grade career. Our first recipient is Annalise Hooten. Abby Hauser. Riley Miller. Taylor Murray. Harold C. Urey Outstanding Achievement Award. Nominees for this award come from the 8th grade student body as well as staff members. All staff and 8th grade students are invited to nominate any 8th grader who they feel is outstanding. We leave it up to the person who is doing the nomination to define outstanding with respect to each person they nominate. This year, 27 8th graders were nominated by the students or staff. Names of the 27 nominees were compiled, and every adult in the building was given a ballot to select the 3 candidates they felt were most outstanding based on their own criteria. Award winners will receive a plaque that honors their recognition, and additionally, their names will be included in a perpetual plaque that hangs in the front foyer of the school. This year's first recipient has been a very quiet but very positive leader in the 8th grade class. He's the textbook definition of a leader by example. He leads with few words but many actions. He doesn't bring attention to himself with his words. As one staff member recently told me, he's one of, if not the most polite and kind students this staff member has ever met. This student has been involved with or won awards including the Caught Doing Good Award, Student of the Month, Honor Roll, President's Academic Award, and the Bob Clark Award. His teachers greatly appreciate the businesslike attitude and approach that he displays every single day. He comes to school with a businesslike attitude and does just that, takes care of business. Congratulations to Bryce Whitmer. Our next outstanding award winner has been involved in several activities during his career here at Urey. Some of the middle school accolades that he has won include multiple times being recognized on the UMS Honor Roll, the President's Academic Award. He's a very active member of the UMS Student Council, perfect attendance, Student of the Month, a member of the football team, and a member of the National Junior Honor Society. In addition, I found out this morning while I stopped in his home room that another student commented that he had nice eyebrows. They're 8th graders. The individual is highly admired and respected as a young adult. Congratulations, Ethan Baker. That this morning, I thought that was going to be golden tonight. Our final recipient has been involved in many activities while being a student these past 2 years at Urey. She's found time to balance her schoolwork with numerous outside of school activities. This is a partial list of her middle school accomplishments. A Distinguished Honor Roll member for 2 years, the President's Academic Award, a member of Sound Sensation, a member of the choir and the band, perfect attendance, track, art club, National Junior Honor Society president. Every time I see her, she always has a smile on her face. Congratulations, Abby Hauser. As we close tonight's program, I want to share a story with you that I shared with them 2 days ago, maybe 3 days ago. I don't remember when it was. We met in the gym. I told them, I said, it was Tuesday, because Monday night, the senior scholarship banquet took place at John Glenn High School, where several scholarships were awarded to seniors for their either athletic, academic achievement, or some other reason. I encouraged them, I'm begging you, to start building yourself a resume of your accomplishments. Take the accomplishments you won tonight, take the accomplishments you've won in the past, and start building that resume, because that's going to help you 4 years down the road, seventh graders, 5 years down the road. The money that is given away in scholarships every year is astronomical. Don't know what the totals were this past week, but it was well over $1 million in money that was given away to the class of 2015, just at John Glenn High School. It's a lot of money. It can be earned in so many different ways. And the traits that you have, the qualities that you have, whether it's personality, work ethic, academics, athletics, music, whatever the case may be, is going to take you a long way in life. Stay focused, keep working, and keep track of those, because it's going to pay off for you in the long run. Parents, one of the highlights of the year is this night. And one of the highlights to me of this night is watching you. You don't know what awards your children are going to win. They don't know what awards they're going to win. And it's fun to watch you smile. It's like a child on Christmas morning. They don't know. They're excited, but you're more excited, I think. And it is a joy to sit here and watch you get excited for their accomplishments. Thank you very much for raising wonderful, wonderful young adults. Thank you and good night.